that you say. Oh man, no way.
Put a lid down on it and everything will be alright.
Put a lid on it.
Oh man.
Put a lid on it.
Oh, man, no.
Put a lid down on it.
Save it for another night.
And welcome to the Genie Power Show. Today, we have guests Stevie Jeevee and Richie Ragu. We're going to have an update from Jiffy Jeff's Gym and a nostalgic video for our video contest. And I guess maybe I'll let Benny Rizzuti come back to his show now. Come on, Benny.
Oh, thank you, Genie. The Genie Powers Gagoot Show. Very good,
Genie. Well, I'm only
going
to be here for a few more weeks. So
I know.
Actually, next week I'm not going to be here. But I'll be back for a few more weeks after that. I know, boo!
We're working out a deal. We're working on something. We're working. I've got my cousin Vinny working on this.
You know what I was thinking the other day, you know, because you call it the Gagoot Show.
Yes.
Isn't that like a zucchini?
Yes.
Because I worked at a farm stand for many years, and we had Gagoots there. So
right.
Is that, are you like a vegetable? Is that like your nickname?
I gave myself that nickname because I grow them. And
okay.
I've turned into my grandfather as I got older. So I have the fig trees, and I have a garden.
Oh, you have fig trees?
Yes.
You
yes.
are totally going to give me figs.
Yeah, I'm totally going to give you figs. I hope they made it, survive the winter.
Did you wrap them?
I wrapped them. I didn't put anything over the roots, though. They said you should put, like, more dirt or mulch.
It was a very cold winter. I hope they survive.
Winter.
I like roasting them.
Oh,
and
really?
Yes, and I put honey and gorgonzola, and I chop up hazelnuts, and I roast them. So good.
Okay, yeah, I have figs and I grow gagoots.
I don't like the gagoots.
No?
No.
I have a great recipe, very Italian, like a sauce. You make it with a can
well,
of tomatoes.
Well, I like the figs because it tastes like candy.
They do. The figs are delicious.
Yum, yum.
They are. Yum, yum. They are. So, how was your week? Happy birthday.
Thank you. Yes,
you're
it was my birthday and I went to the city.
You did?
Yeah. Wait,
you do anything
special? I ate. I go to the city to eat. My family took me to the city so that I could eat good food.
Any place special?
I like going to Rare Bar and Grill. There's a few of them. There's one in Chelsea that I like eating at. It's, you know, a steak place. But I go there and I get the salad. They have this rock shrimp salad with crispy pancetta.
So, and shrimp, yeah.
Yeah, I like eating that. And,
yeah.
I like going to Smorgasburg in Brooklyn.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, it's, I don't know if you've ever heard of that.
No.
It's all different vendors. Like hundreds of vendors from all countries all over the world. Filipino vendors, Bolivian, Ethiopian, very good vendors. And you get like small plates there. Come with an empty stomach and a fat wallet. Because you don't know how many places you want to eat from. So you just keep eating and eating and eating. And before you know it, you're broke. And you're stuffed.
But it's, and you're stuffed.
Yeah, and it's excellent.
So. I've eaten like at Sardi's. The last few places times I've eaten at the city. Sardi's, Hard Rock Cafe.
I try to stay away from those places now. I try to go to like the little places, the out-of-the-way places. I find that the food's much better. I mean, I have gone to those, you know, years ago.
I'm sure the food is much better in those places because the other place is just churning it out.
Yeah, I wanted to go to Chinatown because it was Chinese New Year and because Chinese, Asian. But I didn't get to go down there. It was freezing. My daughter didn't want to walk, so I didn't get to do that. But we did get to go to Mike Dillon's fundraiser.
You went to Mike Dillon's fundraiser.
I did. I made it back in time.
Yeah, that was great. That was really great seeing you were there, Nicole.
Yes.
Stephen Perillo was there. A lot of people.
Joey Cola was there.
Joey Cola. Paul Bond.
Yes, and despite the weather, a lot of people showed up. It was a full house. Richie Ragu was there who helped set up this fundraiser. So.
Yeah, and he'll be on later after with Stevie.
And I know Mike Dillon is watching right now, so hi, Mike Dillon.
Hi, Mike. How you doing? Your 15 minutes of fame isn't over yet. He posted on Facebook yesterday because people were putting... But it was a great turnout for horrible weather.
Yes.
And I still have so many people to thank. I think we'll be thanking them throughout because Madhouse TV was there.
Yes, they were.
They were. And Jerry Parisi and his wife, Michelle Parisi, filmed the whole thing.
Yep,
and now
they were interviewing everybody.
And they're editing it, and we're going to show it on the Gagoot Show.
Oh, great.
Not the Genie Powers Show.
It is the Genie Powers Show. Until the 31st.
Until the 31st. But you'll still be here on the 31st.
Yes, I will be here on the 31st. Boo-hoo, yes. My last air date.
See, you know, we have the Gagoot Show Facebook page. send ideas for how we can keep Jeannie on the show. I've been talking to her about doing videos because we kind of like the two people dynamic. And when Nicole comes back, you know, we like the two people works better.
Yeah.
But we want to have you back. And I know you. Sometimes we'll have you as a guest because there are Tony Landalpi's going to come back.
Oh, yes. And he's a friend of mine, so I would love to be here when
he's here. So we're going to schedule a show where you'll be a guest and Tony will be here. And probably you both together will interview both of you because he's been on the show.
Yes. You know what I wanted to ask you? How's my fan club doing?
Oh, the fan club.
For those of you who didn't watch last week, I heard I had a fan club. What's the name of it? Benny?
Oh, my. I got in trouble for this. So first I want to say I love my wife, Nancy, and she's the most beautiful woman in the world. Out of every woman I ever even spoke to, my wife, Nancy, I love you. Okay, the name of the fan club is The People Who Imagine Jeannie Powers Naked Fan Club. And it started because I was talking about how I had actor's nightmare that I blanked out doing a comedy show, but I started thinking of jokes, and you mentioned...
Think of everyone naked.
Think of everyone naked, because... And I don't know how that would work. I really don't know.
It was on an episode of The Brady Bunch many years ago.
Because I was thinking of that. But anyway, I said that, so...
Well, Rob Civitana said that he wanted to be the president.
He's the president of the... And you said you want also women to be on the fan club. Men and women.
Because it's not,
we don't discriminate. So I signed Nancy up, so she punched me, but she laughed. Because when I first came home, I have to tell you, I came home, and Nancy's watching the Gugut show on the phone. So I say, hi. And she's like, don't you say anything to me. And I was like, what? Why? The first 5 minutes of the show, do you have any idea? You're talking. I said, because, you know, I'm looking for the joke. So we were having fun.
It was a very good show. It was a funny show.
We had a lot of fun on the show with Rob Civitanis and
Cara Amore,
whose name I couldn't pronounce. But Nancy was like, you couldn't pronounce Amore, but Robert Civitanis, he had no problem. So anyway, I hope I'm not spinning a lot. Anyway, she was all angry. And I'm like, what are you talking about? And then when Rob comes on and says he wants to be the president, she sort of became the running theme. Because I didn't think of that.
Do you know how many messages I've gotten on Facebook?
How many?
Lots and lots. Everybody wants to join the fan club. Or they told me they've been a fan club for years. They've been in the fan club for years. Or they're so happy there's finally a fan club.
And
they want to know where they can get their membership. Will they be receiving photos?
But they're imagining you naked.
Yes.
So you're not, you could wear clothes.
I can. But if anyone has ever gone to my Funtasian fan page, the profile shot is an actual cartoon of my naked body with sensor bars over my breasts and my nether regions. So there you go, fans. Just go to my fan page. You could see me cartoon self
and
practically naked.
Yeah, go to the fan page and then become...
And like my fan page, Funtasian.
Yeah, we gave you a nice plug.
Nice little plug for me. Self-promotion all the way.
So Stevie Jeebe says he has a major announcement.
Oh.
But he didn't bring a life coach with him, so.
Oh, thank God.
I think he was he was going to bring Rob Choppy with him.
But I don't think I can handle another life coach this month.
One life coach was enough. And, there was a lot of things I wanted to talk about. I had a lot of fun at the, I'm glad the fundraiser, we'll be talking about it when Richie comes on. But it really was great for that horrible weather and everybody and the lineup. It was just amazing.
And Mike looks great. Mike, you look great.
Yeah, Mike. You do. Everybody put a big smile on his face. It was good. It was
fun.
And
I've been talking to him the last couple of days. We've been joking.
You have?
Yeah, we've been joking back and forth.
He's so happy about it.
He's such a nice guy.
Oh, he is. He's a great guy.
And because everyone showed up, I said it on Facebook, it's just a testament to the type of person he is. That's why everyone came.
And it was, the lineup was an A-list lineup. All the comics were A-list. But we wanted except for me, because I helped out, so they were nice. They pitied me. Yeah, but we were so many comics. Mike has helped out so many people and given them their start that they were the new up and comers, and so we decided on one person who would be the up and comer comic to go on, and it was Stephen Perillo. Because he got his start.
I'm sorry I missed that.
Yeah, he was the only one. And he did great. Everybody loved him because his stand-up act is very funny.
I have seen his stand-up act.
You have, right?
I've seen him at open mics.
All right, and he does some very funny material. But it was unanimously decided he should be the guy to represent one of the new up-and-coming comics because of Mike. He started out with Mike, and he did a lot of photography work for Mike. You know, he's done a lot.
He's a talented
Mike's
kid.
His buddy. Very talented kid. Very talented.
You're a talented right now, kid, Mike. I mean, Steve.
Steve.
Right? And Steve, yes.
Steve, I heard you. I want to say this. I heard that on the way home, Stephen got
he was in an accident, but he is okay.
I hope you're all right, and I want everybody who's watching this to go on Stephen's page and say, hey, we hope you're all right. We heard what happened, and friend him.
I heard he was okay.
Yeah.
And
yeah,
it's pretty bad weather out there right now, so if you're watching live, don't go out and drive. Stay home.
Even if you're watching from Florida, don't go out and drive. If you're this is the World Wide Web.
Or Hong Kong. Or the Philippines. Or Japan, where my family is.
I'm glad you mentioned that.
Because I have family watching
Mario Matsumoto is a big fan. She's
Oh, really?
Yes. She's on a page, born in 1955. So I'm on that page because I know people who were born in 55.
Are you lying about when you were born?
Yeah, I was born in 1955. So anyway,
sure
I had...
Sure you were.
When it was my birthday, in September, I said, hey, everybody, I bought a TV show. And when I put it on, Mario Matsumoto wrote that she lives in Japan and she's been learning English as a second language, so she watches the Gagoot show.
Does she really?
To learn English. And one time, one show, it was Stephen Perillo's birthday. So we did a thing where we were like mentioning everybody's birthday but his.
Uh-huh.
And then we met, and she sent a message to me, tell Stephen happy birthday.
Oh, so she watches every week?
Every week, Mario Matsumoto. And Mario, she must be half Italian.
Or anyway. She's just making it easy for you.
Yeah. No, it's Mario with a Y. Mario.
Okay.
Matsumoto.
All right, yeah. Like Domo Arigato.
Yes,
Mr. Roboto. That's the only Japanese I know, unfortunately. I speak Tagalog. I don't speak Japanese, so I'm sorry, Mario.
Hi, Mario. Anyway, Mario, tell everybody we're going to show a clip now from Jiffy Jeff's gym, as we were talking about Rob Chaffee. We're going to get an update, as we said we would show updates every so often. Here's our first Jiffy Jeff's gym update. And then we'll be back with our first guest, Stevie Jeeby. You're watching the
Genie Power Show here on Madhouse TV. Thank you so much for joining me.
It's a Gagoot Show exclusive.
I am embracing who I am. The big, fat, wide-butted, bloated, gooey, disgusting guy.
That's why I'm here. What we're going to do is we're going to transform this man into a machine. We're going to get him in shape. He's going to feel good on the inside. He's going to feel good on the outside. That's basically what I do. I'm a personal trainer, and we're going to make this guy a thing of beauty.
Jiffy's got me on this supplement program, has me taking all these different pills. One of them is this multivitamin thing like this. Is a protein pill. Gives me extra protein for my muscles. And let's see, what else I got? Oh, wait a second. How'd that get in there?
Brevar. I'm here for Multimedicine in Westbury, New York. We're located at 1065 Old Country Road, Suite 214. Been here for about 15 years. The practice has medical doctors, physical therapists, chiropractors, acupuncturists. We also do pain management, and we have orthopedists on staff. Here at Advanced Multimedicine Rehabilitation, we've got physical therapists on staff who treat an array of conditions, from neck pain to back pain, shoulder pain. We treat carpal tunnel. We treat a lot of car accident patients, slip and falls. We treat patients with knee injuries, with ankle injuries. We have state-of-the-art equipment. We've been here for over 15 years. We do a vast array of diagnostic testing, from x-rays to EMGs. What is an EMG? It's a diagnostic test that allows a doctor to determine where the pinched nerve is. Cora is a physical therapist at Advanced Multimedicine and Rehabilitation. She's working on Stephanie, who was involved recently in an automobile accident. Stephanie has tight thoracic and cervical musculature, and Cora is doing some myofascial release work and some therapeutic stretching doing it to help her with her pain. Vicky is also a patient here at Advanced Multimedicine and Rehabilitation. Vicky is now working her leg muscles, specifically her quadricep muscles, trying to strengthen them after an injury she sustained. Find yourself in need of any type of physical therapy, please don't hesitate to call Advanced Multimedicine and Rehabilitation, located in Westbury, New York, in Suite 214. Phone number is 516-334-7000, or find us on our website at advanced.